This is a lesson with Myra.
Hi.
And she's going to start today with Estudio.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay, Myra, do you have this piece memorized without the music?
Yes.
Can you play it? Okay, now can you play the just the bass notes throughout the performance for me? Now the bass notes throughout this piece are the melody notes. So it's very important that they are brought out and played more emphatically than the rest of the notes.
There it is. Okay, sorry.
Let's play the melody together. It starts with the A, G sharp, the B, A, A, G, F, E, G sharp, A, A. Good. And then now the second part. C arpeggio, do, re, sol, good, back to G, and I go C, down to B, open A, C, B, A, A, again on that second part. Okay, so the point is that throughout this piece, the bass melody is what must sing, and it must be dominant over all the other notes. So when we play this, we're going to do a good strong stroke with the thumb, Now, it's important to make sure that when you're holding your hand, that your wrist is not too flat, that your wrist is coming and it's angled down slightly towards your thumb, so that you can get a very strong stroke with your thumb. Together. We're going to go very slow. We're going to emphasize the bass notes every time with our thumb so it stands out above the accompaniment, which are the notes plucked with the index and middle fingers. Okay? So. Fourth string, Myra, on the F note. Remember, it's this chord. Look at my hand.
Sorry.
F, D, F. Play that note more prominently with the thumb. Okay. Then the open D. Then the E note. G sharp. Let's repeat that one more time, the first section, and let's try to keep it steady and play the bass notes with more prominence. Thank you. much better. Now, it's important to make the thumb note more dominant than the rest when playing, more significant, and played with a slight more emphasis, since it is the melody, and it's what carries throughout the piece. But we must be careful not to pound each note so that it's super accented. It must be played with a great deal of care and very musically. So that's something I want you to focus on in playing this piece. Be mindful of the hand, that your wrist does not get too low, because then it's hard to keep strength in the thumb. And when you do work with the thumb, make sure you're plucking from the base of the thumb, that it is coming from the larger muscle. You can feel a little bit of arm in the stroke. Because if we do the work of the larger muscles, if we let them guide the bulk of the work, we'll save a lot of energy. Let's try it one more time, and we're going to try to keep it musical. The thumb plays the melody, but it's not overdone. Okay? One, E, and two. Section. A little quieter though. The thumb still stands out, but it's quieter overall. Now you have the piece firmly in your memory. I want you to work on smoothing the transitions in the second section. You know, make sure that you keep a steady tempo and don't lose track of the chromatically shifting down melody. And memory slips a couple times with that, but I think you know it. And play it with beauty and expression. Always keep the thumb note louder than the rest of the notes, but that doesn't mean you always play it forte. It's just louder in relation to the other notes. You know?